Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy, and we are going to discuss today about Bellarmine theorem, and this is lecture number 5. I hope you have already watched part 1 to part 4 before watching this part 5. And today we are going to discuss about the miscellaneous exercise miscellaneous question from that, and that we will discuss one by one. So let us start from first question, and the first question is given here that this is a question. That is, find A and B in the explanation. This is miscellaneous exercise. Miscellaneous exercise on chapter 8. Chapter 8. Right now? So, the first question which is going to be discussed today, this is find A and B and N. Find A, B and N. In the expansion of and n in the expansion of a plus b to the power n, if the first three terms in the expansion are if the first three terms in the expansion are given here, that is 729 7290 and 30375 respectively. Alright, this is the question. So you have to deal with this, and the solutions, how can you obtain the solution? Let us write here to solve this question. So solution, for solution, the first three terms in the expansion are in the expansion of a plus b to the power n. Are what will be that? nc0 a to the power n nc1 a to the power n minus 1 b, and nc2 a to the power n minus 2 b square. This is what. So according to question, it is given here that first three term, that is nc0 a to the power n, is given here 729. This employee nc0 is 1, a to the power n is 729, and this employee a to the power n is equal to this is first equation. Okay, we can do that. Now the second term is given nc1 a to the power n minus 1 into b, and that is equal to 7290. This can be written as nc1 is n, a to the power n upon a into b. A to the power n minus 1 can be written as a to the power n divided by a is equal to 7290. This is second equation. So if I put the value of a to the power n from first, third term is nc2 a to the power n minus 2 b is equal to 30375. This is the third equation. So divide second by first. You have here divide second by first. We have nc1 is n, n a to the power n minus 1 b divided by a to the power n, right, is equal to 7290 divided by 729. So it will be n. This power will subtract here, n will be there, nb by a is equal to 10, right now, nb by a is equal to 10 will come. Now divide third by second, we have nc2 a to the power n minus 2 b square, there is b square, all divided by nc1 a to the power n minus 1 b is equal to 30375 divided by 0.90. So what it will come? It will come like NC2 here, NC2 upon NC1 is nothing else but this is N into N minus 1 by 2 and whole divided by N, and this 30375 divided by 7290. So we can write here, this will be nothing else but N minus 1, N into N minus 1 by 2 divided by N, and this is V by A is equal to, if you cancel this by 5, it will be 65 j 30 0 75 j 35 and 55 j 25, and 5 cancel this how many times, 1 4 14, and this is 55 j 25 and 85 j 40, so 6075 divided by 1458. In place of N B by A, here is N and there is B by A, we can write 10 here. So this will be N minus 1 by 2N, this 2 and this N. In this NB by A can be written as 106075 divided by 1458. 2 can cancel this 5 times and 5 can cancel this 1215 times. So what will happen? That will be 12. So that will come like N minus 1458, isn't it? That will be 1458 minus N minus 1458 is equal to 12515 N. So therefore, if this will come this side, it will be 243 N is equal to 1458, and this employee N is equal to 1458 divided by 243, that is 6. So N is 6. Now we can put the value of N here, N is equal to 6, then B by A will be what? Putting N is equal to 6, there will be relation. Anywhere we can do that. Since N B by A is equal to 6 and there 10, this is given, and put N is equal to 6 here. So B by A is equal to 5 by 3, or you can write B is equal to, this will come B is equal to 5 by 3 A. This is equation 4. Now from first, A to the power N is 729 and N is 6 here. Since from first, A to the power N is 729 and A is 6, N is 6. So A to the power 6 is 3 to the power 6. This employee A is 3. And now B is equal to 5 by 3a from 4. We have B is equal to 5 by 3a. So B by 3 into A is 3. So 3 cancel. What is this? B is equal to 5. So B is 5. Okay. And therefore B is 5. So answer is A is equal to 3, B is 5, and N is 6. Now the second question. Let us solve second question from this exercise, this miscellaneous one. It is given that find a if the coefficient of x square and x cube in the expansion of 3 plus ax to the power 9 are equal, right now. So coefficient of x square will be, coefficient of x square can come like where it will come, solution. So if you will write the expansion, then what will happen? 3ax to the power 9 can be written as 9c03 to the power 9 plus 9c13 to the power 8, ax to the power 1, and 9c23 to the power 7, ax square, right? and similarly 9c3 3 to the power 6 ax to the power 3 and so on. This will be the expansion. Now clearly from coefficient of x square will come here. Here the coefficient of, therefore coefficient of x square is 9c2 3 to the power 7 a square, right now x square, and coefficient of x to the power 3 is, and also coefficient of x to the power 3 is 9c3 3 to the power 6 a to the power q. As per the question, it is given that both of them are equal. So according to question, we can write here, according to question, since both of them are equal, 9c3 3 to the power 6 a cube is equal to 9c2 3 to the power 7 a square. So a square can cancel a cube, and this cancel, 3 will left, and 9c3 is what? 9c3 is 9 into 8 into 7 upon 3 into 2, and what is left here? A is left, and 9c2 is 9 into 8 upon 2, and what is left there? 3 left there, right? Now 3 to the power 7, 3 to the power 6 divide, so 3 to the power 1 is left here, a to the power 1 is left. Now 9 and 8 cancel, 9 and 8 cancels, 2 can cancel by 2, and this 3 will come this side. So what will happen? A is equal to, this 3 will come this side, 3 into 3 is 9, and this 7 is divide this side, so 9 by 7, that will be the answer. So value of A can be calculated as 9 by 7. I hope you got it. Okay, so A is 9 by 7. Next question is third. Question number third is there, and third question is, it is given that find the coefficient of x to the power 5. Find the coefficient of, let me start with the new page, right? So we will start with new page. Find the coefficient of, question third is find the coefficient of x to the power 5. Coefficient of x to the power 5 in the product of, in the product of, product of 1 plus x 2x to the power 6, 1 into 1 minus x to the power 7, using binomial theorem, using binomial theorem, right? So we have to find coefficient of x to the power 5 in this expansion. So what we'll do, so solution is, we can write 1 plus 2x to the power 6 multiply by 1 minus x to the power 7. The expansions can be written as 6c0 plus 6c1 2x plus 6c2 2x square plus 6c3 2x to the power 3 plus 6c4 2x to the power 4 plus 6c5 2x to the power 5, isn't it? And plus 6c6 2x to the power 6, but that is not required, right? Now 6c6 2x to the power 6. Here the same expansion, if I'll write here this one, then 7c0 minus 7c1x plus 7c2x square plus 7c minus 7c3, alternate negative sign, now so plus minus, there would be 7c3 x to the power 3 plus 7c4 x to the power 4 minus 7c5 x to the power 5, like that it will come. No need to write further because we have to find x to the power 5 only. So coefficient of x to the power 5 will come from, therefore coefficient of x to the power 5, coefficient of x to the power 5 is given by h. What will come? here power 5 is multiplied by this constant, then power of x to the power 5 will come. That is 7c0 into 6c5 into 2 to the power 5, right? And then power 4 of this and power 1 is of this is will come. So 6c4 into 7c1 and 2 to the power 4, right? Then power 3 of this and 4n1, 2 of this and 3 of this. So that is 7c2 into plus 7c2 into 6c3 into 2 to the power 3 minus 7c3 into x to the power 3 there, and here 6c2 x to 2 to the power 2, isn't it? And then 7c4 into what? 6c1 and 2 power 1, right? And then 1 is 7c5 minus 7c5 into 6c0 minus 7c5 into 6c0. That will come here. This is 2. Okay. Now we can calculate, this is all will contain x to the power 5. So we can calculate it. 7c0 is 1, 6c5 is 6, and 2 to the power 5 is 32, minus 6c4 is 15, and 7c1 is 7, and 2 to the power 4 is 16, plus 7c2 is 7 into 21, into 7c3 is 20, right, into 8, and minus 7c3 is 35, into 6c2 is 15, and 2 to the power 2 is 4, right? Okay, now then 7c4 is also equal to 35, so plus 35 into 6c1 is 6 and 2 to the power 1 is 2, minus 7c5 is 21 and 6c0 is 1. So we can have this calculation like this is a slightly lengthy one, boring things, but you have to do this. 6 to 12, carry 1, 6 3 18 and 1 19, minus, I can write here all these calculations together. So after calculating all these, it will be 171, and that will be answer of this question. I hope you will get it. You will do it. If there is any mistake in calculation, you will also check it. Now the next question is, question number 4, and it is given that if A and B, let me write clearly, if A and B are distinct integer, prove that A minus B is a factor of A to the power N minus B to the power N whenever N is a positive integer. Whenever n is a positive integer. So this is a question. Distinct integer, prove that a minus b is a factor of a minus b whole to the power n. So we can do it. The solution is, we can start from a to the power n can be written as a minus b plus b whole to the power n. That can be written as a minus b is one factor and b is another factor and whole to the power n. Now further this can be expanded as a to the power n is equal to, this implies a to the power n is equal to a minus b plus b whole to the power n. This can be expanded by using binomial expansion nc0 a minus b to the power n plus nc1 a minus b to the power n minus 1 into b. And similarly, if I'll write here ncn minus 1, then a minus b will be power 1 only and b to the power n minus 1, and last term will be ncn b to the power n, right? So further it can be written as a to the power n is equal to, in all the x terms, this one, till this one, there is a power a minus b can be taken common. So a minus b, if I would take common from all these, then this will be nc0 a minus b to the power n minus 1, because 1 a minus b is taken common. Here nc1 a minus b to the power n minus 2, because a minus b has been taken common. And similarly, there will be ncn minus 1 b to the power n minus 1. Here a minus b will not left. And ncn is 1, so plus b to the power n will come, because ncn is 1. Now, if this b to the power n can be taken this side, it will be a to the power n minus b to the power n. And here it will be left as a minus b nc0 a minus b to the power n minus 1 plus nc1 a minus b to the power n minus 2 b plus like this up to ncn minus 1 b to the power n minus 1. So clearly this has a minus b is a factor, so we can write here this will be a minus b into some positive things, positive quantity, right? And therefore, a to the power n minus b to the power n is a minus b is a factor of, is a factor of a to the power n minus b to the power n. This is the proof, right now? Okay, now question number 5. See, the question number 5 is there, and this fifth question is about, given that evaluate root 3 plus root 2 to the power 6 minus root 3 minus root 2 to the power 6. The similar question we did in exercise as well. So how to deal with, we know you can use it directly, that a plus b to the power n minus a minus b to the power n is twice of nc0, and the subtraction twice of odd, na? So twice of odd will left nc1 a to the power n minus 1 b plus nc3 a to the power n minus 3 b to the power 3, isn't it like this? So put here the same things, if a is equal to root 3 and b is equal to, if I put similarly, so put a is equal to root 3 and b is equal to root 2, then you will have here root 3 plus root 2 to the power 6 minus root 3 minus root 2 to the power 6 is equal to twice of 6c1 a is root 3 to the power 5 and root 2 to the power 1 plus 6c3 root 3 to the power 3 and root 2 to the power 3, right now? And then 6c, we can write 6c terms will be 6c5 root 3 to the power 5 and root 2 to the power 1, and there will be 6c7 is not possible, so these are the terms. Now if you calculate this, so therefore root 3 plus root 2 to the power 6 minus root 3 minus root 2 to the power 6, and this will be twice of 6c1 is 6 and root 3 to the power 5 is 9 root 3 into root 2 plus 6c3 is 20, 20 into root 3 to the power 3 is 3 root 3, and this is 2 root 2, and 6c5 is 6 and root 3 to the power 5 is again, this was root 3 to the power 1, so root 3 into 2 root 5 is 4 root 2. I hope you got it. And finally, this will come like, therefore, it will be equal to 2 times of 9th, 6 is 54, 54 root 6 प्लस 23 जा 60 एंड 62 जा 120 रूट 6 प्लस 64 जा 24 रूट 6 एंड दैट विल बी 78 एंड 198 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2 इज 82 जा 16 19 396 रूट 6 आंसर आई थिंक सो. So these are few things that we have discussed in this lecture. Now it's time for break. Take a break and thereafter we will complete the remaining topic. So thank you very much for watching this, and after break we will complete this topic. Thank you. Thank you very much.